Welcome to the voice of the Lord. Our verse for today is Romans chapter 3, verse 3. What if some did not have faith? Will their lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? This can be a general question that we can ask ourselves. What if some of the Christians today do not have faith in God? Will their lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? Well, the answer of the Apostle Paul is not at all. Let God be true and all men be a liar, he said. And it's so true, friends, that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the Son of Man that he should change his mind. What he said that he will do, friends, if he promised something, God will surely fulfill those promises because he is faithful. And therefore, if some, remember, friends, not all, if some Christians do not believe in him, well, they call themselves believers, but there are times when by their actions they don't show faith in him. Will God nullify his faithfulness? No. Well, this is the reason also why the Lord Jesus Christ was emphasizing, friends, that in that day only a few will be saved. Because some will not have faith in him. Only those that will have faith in God will be saved. Those that will hold on to the faith that they have in the Lord Jesus Christ, those are the ones that will be saved. And not a lot, friends, in the last days. That's what Jesus had said. Because in the last days, there will be this apostasy or falling away that will come. And this will come to those who don't believe. And therefore, to us, friends, today, let us believe. Amen. Let us believe. What God had said will surely come to pass. That's why he said that heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. Therefore, make that firm decision to hold on to the word of God. He is faithful, regardless of what others will do. Remember that the Lord will deal with us individually, personally. For as long as there is you, there is me, God remains faithful. Hallelujah. That's why the Apostle Paul used the word some. What if some, not all? Because there will always be one that will believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And for the sake of that one, God will remain faithful. Amen. Well, we could see it, friends, in the way that Abraham negotiated with God when God was about to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. Well, Abraham said, what if there is even 10 people or 5 people in the city? Will you destroy it? God said, no. Well, the negotiation started with 50 down to 10 or 5. But God said that for the sake of the righteous in the city, I will not destroy it. And therefore, friends, for the sake of you and me, God will remain faithful. Amen. Though we are faithless, even the Apostle Paul was saying that, though we are faithless, God remain faithful. Hallelujah. And so, in that faithfulness of God, he will forgive us. Yes, we might stumble sometimes, or from time to time, we might sin, friends, but the faithfulness of God remains that he will forgive those who come to him in repentance. So today, let us repent if you believe that you have sinned against God. If you have fallen short of his glory, repent and be restored. Amen. That restoration is in accordance with God's faithfulness because he will not turn away from his words. We are born again and therefore, friends, he will remain true to us because he is our Father. Hallelujah. So may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And lift up his countenance and give you his peace, his shalom. God bless. See you again next time. Bye.